They parted company, so now there are two backers doing the rounds, as if one wasn't enough.
I know a narrow street that winters have forgotten, and the springtime from her jealousy does not let her blossoms bloom. But who cares, since I...
Nana's lost her marbles and come to London to get them back.
Maybe one day the marbles of Parthenon that are in the British Museum, they could come back to their own birthplace.
So Nana continues her campaign, and while they won again in 83, Luxembourg haven't even bothered to enter for the last 6 years. Past the Duchy, that's Luxembourg. 38 appearances, winners 5 times, 85 points, and given up the ghost.
Well, couture has never been more out than on the Eurovision stage. It just shows you what can be achieved, even on a tight budget, with little imagination, and the keys to the Doctor Who wardrobe room. Yet the
So, what they say about horizontal stripes adding a pound or two is true, then. They didn't win, but they were inundated with job offers as Christmas decorations. More hoes than the London Fire Brigade. No, not OK at all, actually.
Boom, bang, a bang, a bunny bee, a bunny bar, ding, ding, a dong. It's songs like these that break down geographical borders and unite whole countries in the common language of laughter.
La, la.
Boats, raping and pillaging. Then they came with their out-of-town superstores selling, let's face it, affordable self-assembly furniture, even if we don't understand the names in the catalogues. Yes, at five, it's the land of herrings and meatballs.
Won't you take me to your heaven, to your heart?
Sweden may be the current reigning Eurovision champions, but it took a long time and a lot of hard work to get it right.
April, dumma, stillar, kan du lura vad du vill?
In the 60s, they experimented unsuccessfully with the jaunty whistle, but by the early 70s, a new prototype was in development in Stockholm. Two girls, one blonde, one dark, two boys might have something here. But the judges didn't think so. Maybe it was the plaster cast, maybe it was one beard too many, maybe the song was just shit. Back to the drawing board.
We had decided, I think, to, you know, to try to do something with what then wasn't ABBA, but Bjorn, Benny, Frida and Agneta.
1 year later, two girls, one blonde, one dark, two boys, just the one beard this time, but they didn't make it past the qualifying heats. It could have been the name.
People were constantly referring to us, and they had to refer us to us as something. And to say Bjorn, Benny, every time you refer to a group like that is impossible. Then we had a competition, I remember, in a Swedish evening paper. Or what should they be called? And something like 80% said ABBA. There is a fish cannery in Sweden called ABBA, which is the biggest one, really. All the herrings we get from there, and we had to ask them, weren't they? Yes, they said, it's fine as long as you don't dabble in fish.
So, one fish-free year later, same band, same place, new name. This time, success, and the Eurovision stage in England's glamorous Brighton beckoned.
We travel out there and we had a whole country behind us and all the hopes of the country on our shoulders.
But due to IRA bomb threats, the most historic Eurovision win of all time almost didn't happen.
I remember that my bedroom was between the Irish and who was else that was fighting at that time. And I thought, well, this is going to be, you know, I'm there. I'm a sitting duck for this. Incidentally, I was also had the most enormous and very fluffy and very molting boa, feather boa. And every time I moved, I left a trail of feathers around. I thought, well, they always know how to kill me.
But using cunning camouflage, Abba dodged the terrorist threats, and the show did go on. Yeah.
I didn't dare think that this could win, and I certainly never did when we were there. There were, you know, contenders, difficult ones.
I feel like I win when I lose.
Benny said that it was about the most exciting thing in his life. You know, to watch those 12 points come in, and then realizing, I think there were three countries left, or four or something, and it was already, we had enough.
Waterloo.
I remember, he went through my mind. This means overnight, this means something spectacular. The whole world is suddenly open for us.
And that indeed was the start of the big time for ABBA. But while they spent the next 10 years scaling the dizzy heights of success, Sweden's Eurovision career was left to plumb the murky depths. Until this. But although it won, it also managed to flush Swedish street cred straight down the pan.
It may be not the worst song. It may just be the golden boots that they wore on the night. I mean, that was shocking in its own right.
We were very well prepared, extremely well. We knew it, the song and the dance and the singing. I mean, in our sleep backwards. We had rehearsed it, I mean, forever and ever. So, no, I wasn't nervous about the performance itself.
You'll be disappointed to learn that Rick and his brothers have since disbanded.
Time moves on. We were basically a boys band, or, you know, like the all the boys band now, dancing and singing. We were, then we're not boys anymore.
Regrettably, that wasn't the end of choreographic crime by Swedish winners.
I enjoyed having the dancers with me to even underline the power in the song.
But Carola's victory was anything but clear-cut, which caused much wailing and gnashing of teeth in the French camp.
First,
France, 12 points.
It's a draw.
France, 12 points.
It's a draw. 146 points each.
This time, 1991, the Eurovision law was to count the 12s and to count the 10s.
Sweden have won it. Sweden have had more top votes. That's 12 votes.
For me, it was rubbish anyway. And